Mostly used modern X-ray tubes are Coolidge hot cathode tube with a rotating anode. Let's begin with cathode side, the negative terminal of an X-ray tube. Cathode is comprised of a filament or two. A focusing cup. Support for cathode assembly. Filament is a source of electron in an X-ray tube. Filaments produce electrons on heating. In the anode side, we have anode disc. Molybdenum stem. Rotor of induction motor. Bearings. Anode disc rotates with rotor. These tube parts so far discussed, cathode and anode assembly, are kept inside a glass or metal envelope. Glass envelope provides vacuum, mechanical support, and electrical insulation. Stator of induction motor is kept outside glass envelope, around rotor. AC power supply, applied to stator, causes rotation of rotor inside glass envelope. This is how anode rotation inside vacuum is achieved from outside. Anode of an X-ray tube is kept at higher potential or made positive. Cathode is kept at a lower potential or made negative. Filament is heated on application of electric current, and a heated filament emits electrons. X-rays are produced from anode in all directions due to bombardment of electrons. Lead or brass is used to absorb most of the photons traveling in directions other than patient. X-rays are available only in the direction of patient. The space between glass envelope and tube housing is filled with a special oil. Oil used for electrical insulation between high KV components and tube housing. Oil also helps in cooling of X-ray tube by taking away the heat generated inside tube. Expandable gasket. Being a liquid, oil is incompressible. Oil gets heated up and expands inside a tube. Expanding oil pushes away inner flexible part of gasket and creates extra space. Please like, share, subscribe and keep all notification on for update.